Sarah, would you be willing to kick things off by talking a little bit about your process? How long did it take you to write the book? And was the final book that you created the book that you had in mind when you first sat down to write it?
Well, those are great questions. And first off, thank you so much to The Strand for hosting us tonight. It is such an honor to be here. Thank you to everyone here for coming out. I see so many friendly faces and it just warms my heart, so thank you. And thank you, Jenny, for moderating this conversation.
Yeah.
Jenny combines two of my favorite things, one of which you probably like and one of which you probably don't, trans advocacy and reality television.
Oh,
Jenny was on TV.
Wait, which one do they like? Oh, I
You know, after, as I'm sure everyone knows, much of this story is about my relationship with this incredible human being, Andy Craig, who passed away from cancer in 2014. And shortly after he passed away, I went home for a couple weeks to just reflect and work through the grief. And I sat down at my kitchen table and decided that I would just sort of write down what happened. It turned out to be about 15 pages, just to sort of wrap my mind around what I had just gone through. And I ended up sitting on that for a long time, and then on the 1 year anniversary of our wedding, I decided to pare it down a little bit and write a short story that I posted on Medium talking a little bit about our relationship. And I think it was sort of through that experience that I recognized the power that our relationship might have in helping to underscore a very simple fact about transgender people, which is that we are people. And I know, shocking.
Wait, I'm gonna write this down.
Just take notes. And so I began to share that story more and more in my advocacy, and then eventually on stage at the Democratic Convention in 2016. And
applause
it was,
for applause. Well, and I know I'm interrupting you, but that was no small thing. I believe, to paraphrase, in fact, to directly quote Vice President Joe Biden in a different context, that was a big fucking deal.
It was.
Sorry, Mom. Yeah, I'm sorry.
That's okay. I'll say the same thing.
Yeah, she said that right after.
I did.
And the next day, I got an email from my agent, Katie Zanecchia, who wasn't my agent at the time, and she said, "Have you ever thought about writing a book?" And, you know, a couple people had talked to me about that before, but it seemed so presumptuous for me in my mind as a 26-year-old person at that time to write a book. But I think it took Katie coming to me, someone from the industry, and saying, "I believe in the power of this story, and I believe that this is a story that's worth telling." So I started working with Katie on a proposal, then had the great fortune of connecting with folks at Crown, who I eventually signed with as my publisher.
And Crown, a fine publisher of many fine books.
Including...
Oh, no. We share a publisher.
We share a publisher. And worked with them starting in January of 2017 through June of 2017, writing this book. So it was a relatively short period of time. But one of the things that was actually really powerful for me in writing this book was it was right after the election. And I was feeling not particularly hopeful. I was pretty depressed, and I actually had conversations with my parents pretty frequently throughout this period of time where my father, he said to me, because I had to go out and do my public advocacy, and I was having this sort of crisis of faith, and he said, you sort of feel like a pastor has to go out and preach and is having a crisis of faith. And so one of the things that writing this book allowed me to do was to sort of refine my hope and take lessons from my life that I hadn't really connected or seen until writing this book, and really be able to internalize them, find that hope, write this book, and figure out how to move forward.
Wow. Thank you for all that. So much to think about and to react to there.